All right, and of course, you're still watching Aben today, right here on Aben Television. Getting into our Hello Aben this morning, we do have an interesting letter. But before we get into that letter, one was kind enough to head over to our Twitter and, of course, ask us for help. Now, she came up to say that, can a man who took your virginity love you till marriage? Please, I need some advice.
Never.
Yeah, that was on our Twitter page right there.
He can't.
Never, Willis.
He can't.
Why not? Why do you say never?
He can't.
Why do you say never? A man can love you. And before you kept your virginity, chapter 35, he's 50.
They break your virginity.
Okay, maybe if you fucked her,
they love you.
If you fucked her in the age B, then maybe I can believe that. But let's say at age 16 or age 17, you really think that kind of youngster can actually, you know, will walk you down the aisle 35 years?
You never know. I mean, we have very many people who are married. And they married while they were young. I mean, just take a case of Humphrey Wampula. He's a very young married man.
Unless if that comes in phase.
So there's a possibility that he took his virginity.
I take all your virginity, break up with you, then maybe 5 years down the road, I probably link up with you, and then we start where we left off. But it's always a never do because, my goodness, you just don't know. At that point, it's about the sex. But you don't know in your head, am I really going to marry her at the time? Especially when it's actually at a very tender age.
Of course, at a very tender age.
Now, you, Willis, when did you lose your virginity?
I'm a star.
I may not answer that on national TV.
Watch me, though.
But I will answer you in person.
Okay, give us like a time frame.
After school, I will give you the experience.
Was it between 14
the
to
good
18,
and the bad, all that after
19
the show.
To 25?
After school, maybe?
No,
school.
Let me pre... What? What did I say? Preempt. Preempt? Let me come back along after the show. Mbabuli day. Jabawa info bulichimu. Bagambe when I lost it, who I lost it to, how I lost it.
For how long you lost it?
I'll tell you that stuff.
Okay,
after.
So Miss D, yes, it's very possible for one to take your virginity and love you and even walk you down the aisle. It's very possible. I mean, who knows? But also if you lost your virginity when you are 16, 17, I mean, if you don't meet this guy again, then it may not be possible. But if you keep your virginity up to the age of 20, 30, yeah, it's very possible that a man like Nicholas would walk you down the aisle. I just used the name Nicholas.
How many girls in Kampala are 30 or 25 and they still have that?
There are very many. You'd be surprised.
If she's not having a child,
there's someone who attacks. I just feel like I should just throw this phone in their heads.
But there are a number of them. Very many.
But they're there. I wouldn't say there are very many.
I wouldn't blame it entirely on the parents, you know, for being negligent, for their kids losing their virginity. But again,
but virginity is
we're now in the 21st century. So
losing it is a personal choice.
It's really a personal choice. It doesn't mean that if you're a virgin, you're the most holiest person. Or if you're not a virgin, you're the dirtiest person, you're evil. No.
There's a point in time whereby I would wish to invite the producer on set, you know, to come and talk to us. Vanessa.
That's the dean of unvirgin. If she came in contact with Virgin Mary would die.
Like literally would die.
Virginity and Vanessa in the same sentence. No.
Hello, Aben. Our letter here is saying that I have been dating this wonderful woman for 3 years now. We seem to be fine, except one thing. I have never met any of her relatives. Every time the conversation comes up, she evades it and changes topic or just makes inconclusive promises that one day I will meet them. My question is, am I in a normal relationship or I am just wasting time?
Yeah, Muswaza. I was every time they bring up a conversation of let's meet my dad, so rather let me go meet your parents. They're like, no, it's okay. Manya muswaza.
No,
they are ashamed of your physicality. So I would imagine that boy, that young man, should actually think twice about being involved in that relationship anymore.
They could be. It's not because they're ashamed of you. They could be ashamed of their parents.
But
it's
of your parents.
Even if my father was short like you, my father. And there is no way.
There are people who are young in the mind, and they do those things we used to do when we were still in S1, where your dad comes to school and they come without the car this time.
I know where you're going. Where you're heading with that story?
And you're like,
cigarette wango yo.
Eh, o cigarette runga.
Baria mo.
Muga matata
mukwana. Awala molekera wangu.
Muga matata wangu.
Molekera imize.
Matata wanga sindi sasa. Jana
kwa kuku vidi.
Ochseki.
Vidi.
Yeah.
Abuza yeti sechi bakuli cha cha ebinye. You know they are showing love to
So there are people who are still young like that, even though they are like 35, 40, they're still like that. They are scared of their parents, they don't want to show their parents in public, they don't want to associate with them, they are not proud of their home. Even when they do a kwanjura, they hire a home to do a kwanjura, they're not proud of where they are from. Mm-hmm. So you may not be the problem as a guy, the problem could be her. Because she's scared, you know, you're going to judge her, you're going to say, and most especially these slay queens we see in Kampala. She's in Kampala, she has a big life. Some guy is paying for her a very expensive apartment.
You know how they say,
let's meet your parents. We shall go. You're not wasting your time.
I think you should persist.
You're not, you just, there are two things. One, she might be ashamed of you like that, but I think the bigger picture, she's ashamed of her parents. So just give it time and see where the relationship goes. Plus, keep some options on the side.
Or he might do, or she might do that, and eventually the guy turns out to be a lumpen. And obviously the parents have this thing, whoever you bring in this compound should be the man you're going to marry.
That too.
Okay, now guys, I think the problem here is not meeting the parents. The problem is meeting any relative. What this guy is saying is that he has never met a brother, he has never met a sister, a cousin, like nothing.
Maybe she's been hurt in the past.
Really? For 3 years? Yeah. You've been with someone for three years?
No, she's been hurt before you. And that's why it's taking this long, because she needs to be absolutely sure.
You've been with someone for 3 years, and Willis, you have never even introduced them to your brother.
It hurts a lot when you have to introduce to your brothers and family a new person every 3 years.
It's
ridiculous. So as a person, you lose your ego. Your ego dies, your guts are down. So, you know, you say, I need to be absolutely sure that Nick is not going to leave me before I introduce him to my family. That could also be a cause. Now, she's not sure that you're there. So you need to do a lot as a man to, you know, show her you're there.
I think my advice for this gentleman would be very simple. You may not be wasting your time, but have you actually taken an initiative upon yourself to introduce, you know, your relatives to this girl? You could just do these things for courtesy, you know, it will spark something, you know, bring over your brothers, your sisters at home, you know, have a good time, you know, show them the lady, make sure that the lady is comfortable with them. Once in a while, have dinner with your mother when the lady is around, and who knows, in a couple of months from now, she'll be like, I think, you know, this could be the right guy. Like Willis has mentioned, you know, this lady is trying to look for a surety that this is the guy I want to spend the rest of my life
but
with.
In most cases, in most cases, it is her who is ashamed of her parents. Very humble parents with a humble lifestyle. And she's like, she has given you this image of, man, I'm done with campus, Richie. How can I show you my parents? And you go and tell your friends.
I think that means you're wasting your time if that is the situation right there. But our studio lines are going to be open immediately after the break. We're going in for the number to call is 0414-337872. The number is right there on your screens. You can write it down and get some airtime. And when we do get back from this short break, you call us and let us know what advice should we give to this young man right here who has been in a relationship for 3 years, but apparently the girlfriend has never introduced him to any of the relatives. Now, his question is he in a normal relationship or he's actually wasting time? Studio line will be open right after this break.